We have with us today the Secretary of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Mr. Narendra Kumar Sinha. He's with us and we are really privileged to have him. So I'll invite him on the stage, sir. Shri N.K. Sinha is a career civil servant, at present posted at Secretary, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India. He was born in Bihar, is a Bachelor of Technology Honours, Gold Medalist from Information Technology, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi, Master of Engineering in Electrical Engineering with distinction from Indian Institute of Sciences, Bangalore. He has also done Master of Business Administration in 98 from Southern Cross University, Australia. He's a Fellow of Institution of Engineers. After joining Indian Administrative Service in 1980, he held several field posting and worked grassroots, from grassroots to higher levels of governance and public policy making functions of the state and central government. During his more than 37 years in the civil service, he has worked in the diverse area of governance and public policy. The Elecon software used by the Election Commission of India for conducting election has been conceptualized and got developed by him during his tenure as District Magistrate Nalanda in 1989. He has also led the efforts for smart card-based driving license and registration certificate as Transport Secretary and Commissioner in Bihar. In his tenure as Joint Secretary and Additional Secretary in Ministry of Human Resource Development, National Mission on Education from Information and Communication Technology was approved with an outlay of more than 4,612 crores called Sakshar. One-stop education portal was launched. One GPPS optic fiber connectivity were given to 400 universities and 19,000 colleges. Akash 1 and Akash 2 low-cost tablets were also launched in a massive effort for content creation for various engineering and science courses, and creation of virtual laboratories, etc., were taken up under his leadership. As Principal Secretary IT, he conceptualized a massive scheme of providing digital literacy at least to one woman in every household of Bihar, and then to empower them through low-cost access devices to bring them into the mainstream of digital era. Formerly, he has also served as Secretary of Ministry of Culture, which was inter alia mandated with the responsibility of policy formulation and implementation of conservation and preservation of tangible and intangible cultural heritage of India. Welcome you, sir. So we have Ms. Samantha Ramalu from Method Digital. So we invite you onto the stage. Please come. And she is the managing director and co-founder of Method, an award-winning creative innovative agency, and M-Theory, and AR-VR experience agency. Since 2003, Method has worked with clients to create unique and compelling experiences for marketing, communications, and entertainment through web, mobile, game, and emerging technology. M-Theory is a separate arm of Method and focuses on delivering interactive, immersive, and awe-inspiring experiences through a range of AR and VR services. This includes 360 video, post-production, 3D modeling, and digital storytelling, along with computer-generated imagery, apps, and game development. Welcome, Ms. Ramalu. Then we also have Mr. Yuji Yamaha. He's a senior manager from NHK Japan. Please come on the stage. Mr. Yamaha is the senior manager of NHK Engineering Administration Department in Tokyo. He started his career as an engineer of outside broadcasting department. He's been working for live events such as news, sports, and entertainment. In 2008, he moved to NHK General Bureau of America, New York, as a senior engineer to supervise operations in the United States. From 2012, he started working for producing 8K events such as 2014 World Cup, 2015 MLB Baseball. He currently is planning department. He is in planning department and is responsible for the new services and procurement management of NHK's 8K equipment. Welcome, Mr. Yamaha. So we have a very, very distinguished panel today, and we would start with our secretary, Mr. N.K. Sinha. So you would like to give a presentation?
Panelists on the dais and esteemed delegates, What I am going to describe today, this morning, is the way I look at storytelling and technology. It is not necessary that everyone would have the same thoughts. It is not necessary that everyone would be agreeing with what I have to say. But I am going to mention something that we need from the technological advancements that have taken place so far, and perhaps give a nudge for the technology to move in that direction. Because without dreaming, perhaps it would not be possible to come out of the very easy to get commercial instincts of technology. If we have to have something very basic research in technology to help the humanity, perhaps we'll have to move away from the normal routine of what I call incremental research and development, where we do something, immediately encash it, and then think of the next one. We all have also been hearing a number of times that many new things have already been invented, but not yet brought to the market, because the market needs to be milked by what has already happened in earlier years. So a thing that is invented today will perhaps hit the market 3, 4, 5 years later. But in the meantime, something else which was discovered earlier years, that will come to the market, capture the market, get commercialized, and then gradually it moves. So no offense meant to anyone, but if we look at it from the perspective of humanity and how we should move forward, perhaps for a minute or two, we should also ponder over that. The session is technology in storytelling. Obviously, the first question which would come to anyone's mind is, what is a story? Have we defined it? Everyone may have some concept of a story, so do I have. Is it a collection of words and sentences which can transmit information and create emotions and feelings that the author wished to create in the readers? Well, let's tentatively take that kind of definition and ask the second question. Where does it emanate? Does it emanate from our perceptions and feelings which we want to communicate to the society with certain laudable objectives and at times as demonstration of our literary talent also? So we will have to answer these things in the manner that we perceive it and then move on to the next step. The next step is technology. So how does technology encapsulate the concepts and content of the story? How do we merge the two different spheres? We have to gain from the technological sphere and put it into the story sphere. How does the technology help propagate the story? Our stories regarding experiences, history, folklore, scriptures, etc., first got depicted on stones, which were mostly static, and then came bhojpatras, on which our culture was described, including mythology. And then came paper, radio, TV, internet, DTH, and now we have virtual reality, augmented reality, 3D projections, artificial intelligence. So we have been moving. But something of a storytelling has been with us from those times when we perhaps didn't know what was technology. Even without knowing, the humankind has been using these things. Now let's move on to another strand of thought. How many stories can we remember and recall? Can stories impact our lives? Why do we need stories in the first place? For entertainment, for positivity, for imbibing moral values or for becoming better citizens. Some of these things, these points, I would like to expand a bit in a few minutes from now. Story with impact in a customized environment for every individual. Can it happen? How do we balance what the listener expects to see or hear and what the writer intends to portray? And how can technology help us? Now we have to keep in mind, and I expect that our panelists who are from the technology field will also keep this in mind when they are giving their presentations. 3-4 simple questions, but they are thought-provoking. If we presume that a story is a content, which it is, and to some extent content can be visualized as a story, then let's draw an analogy. In writing software, we do not keep reinventing the wheel. We use standard functions and blocks of codes which have already been tested and tried and optimized. Similarly, can a story be created participatively by many authors using packages of information and emotions, etc.? Does technology take us in that direction? Next question, which we should ponder over, is it necessary that a story be perceived by us only through our sensory inputs? Or can stories be catalyzed in the brain directly? I mean, these things may seem to be out of context here, but then we have been thinking over it. If we say a story, the power of the story should not only flow through the sensory inputs that we have. It might be just like our dreams. It perhaps might be catalyzed in our brain directly. And then what happens? What can happen is, can stories be a medium for knowledge transfer and assimilation in the brain to catapult human beings to a higher plane of existence and cognition? If we are able to move in that direction, perhaps we will be impacting on the future of humanity. Perhaps these two powerful elements of story and the technology will give us something tangible and really take us to the higher plane of existence. So if these are the things, if these are the things that we can keep in mind while deliberating, maybe we reach nowhere. Let me tell you, on these issues, we have been breaking our heads for past 10 months. We have had so many discussions with expert groups, and still we feel that we have perhaps moved a millimeter or so. Because this involves so many things. It is not only a technology in that sense. It involves psychology, it involves cognition, it involves brain, it involves irregular, whatever we mean by the technology. So if we can keep this holistic picture in mind, perhaps we would be able to derive much more from whatever is the collective wisdom of humanity at this point of time. Some of the points that I mention now may get repeated in what I have already said. The content library with customizable faces or characters, easily doable. Enhancing the retentivity. And when I say retentivity, why? We all know for our cognitive functions, we use hardly 10% of our brain. Out of the rest 90%, some must be going to maintain our biological existence. But then some may still be available for further expansion. Can we retain? Can our brain become something like a supercomputer and a super storage, which can help us in future? Can we do the assimilation without being awake? Can our other 90% of brain keep on processing the data and assimilating and then one fine morning gives us to the cognitive brain that, hey, this is the solution. We don't know how our great scientists got the ideas. Some people say it came from aliens, but then why not from their own brain, which might be possible? Why don't we explore that? We all have the technology of immersive storytelling. With 70, 90 people are giving any kind of name, perhaps without realizing what a dimension means. Well, somebody can also say 11 dimensions. But how do we polish our stories in that fashion where everything could be utilized? Can we also use other sensors to access the brain? Can we also use other wavelengths which we don't see to impact and give more weight to the stories? Can we explore the subconscious brain for lasting impact? All these questions do come up. Where are we? If we have to explore this universe, we have to explore our mind. And that is where our great philosophers have been telling us that look within and you will be able to find what exists in the universe. Very briefly, in the passing, on the content delivery side, there could be some disruptive changes because internet bandwidth is becoming almost free for the users. Personalized viewing devices are taking over from the television sets, and flat screens to immersive screens, direct reception from satellites, Internet of Things, AI-based solutions, etc. We have to think from the content developer side how to create from entertaining content to infotaining content, and we would gradually move towards usable content, usable stories. Who has the time only for entertainment to listen to a story? Unless it gives us something, unless I can use that story in my day-to-day activity or in my research activity or whatever. Can the technology and story fusion lead us to the direction of directly beaming to us any kind of help, and can it guide us at that point of time in whatever situation we may be in this world? Can that start happening? If I want to know something, can the technology deliver that kind of a story nugget to us? This is how it is done. Well, it should not be impossible. And then we also have the content explosion. How to manage that? How to manage the IPR? The kind of explosion and the kind of knowledge creation that is taking place perhaps will need artificial intelligence solutions to capture and ensure fairness and intellectual property rights to the author. If we are not moving in that direction, after a point of time, because of our paucity of time in our daily lives, the stories may lose their relevance. We are also moving at different pace in different strata of society, as we are becoming more and more knowledge society. So the requirements will be diverse. Knowledge society at level A will need one different kind of treatment so far as the stories are concerned. At B will need something else. At C level will need something else. We also have the fortune of having the fusion of content, telepresence, which may lead to real-time, immersive, and interactive content, which may meander through the dynamic prism of viewer preference and story evolution. And on one hand, create limitless opportunities for the viewers and content creators, and on the other hand, bring up huge challenges to the self-regulating industry. Having said that, let's ask ourselves a question. Have we trained our brains to higher cognition levels to factor in the infrared, ultraviolet, and so many other things which we are not even able to perceive, apart from the normal visible spectrum. So far as the content creation and content delivery is concerned, will it not start an era of multidimensional broadcasting or storytelling? If technological development opens up this realm, then who will train our brains and open up the vistas of something we have been missing out so far? They, being physical entities, can be transmitted to the brain using transducers. Something can happen where I was mentioning bypass our sensory things. This could lead to a faster behavioral change in the audience and viewers, if that be the agreed goal between the content creator and the content consumer. So the question is, are we ready? And my last point is that whatever thinking and research we have been doing over past 10 months, one nugget came out. Perhaps meditation and yoga can be a great help to train our minds, our brain, and keep us focused on the path of this combination of technology and story. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. That was really a detail about what are the questions posed before us and how our brains can be really trained. Thank you very much, sir.